Hi, I'm Chris Sherm. I'm the global director for the Cutmaster Plus family that you see in front of you today. Very excited about it. The 30, the 50, the 70. Today I'm going to go over the 30 Plus and show you all the features, benefits of it. And really, it's a really exciting machine. This machine is a 230 volt single phase machine. Comes with the plug on it for that 16 amp, 230 volt, 16 amp plug. And when you turn it on, it's gonna give you a beautiful bright screen that's gonna communicate with you, right? So it's giving you all the information right there on the front of the screen. I can step through the menus here for you as well. So I've got regular cutting, expanded metal cutting. Expanded metal is like metal that's got holes in it, something like this. Like it looks like a grate. You might have the standard expanded metal, right, that's been stretched. That is what that feature's for, 2T and 4T. 4T is when you connect like an automated torch or something that you want to have a control trigger on, but you don't want to stand there holding it the whole time. You can turn it on, release it, and then pull the trigger again to turn it off. So if you were connected to like a track torch or a pipe beveler, that's where you would use that in conjunction with like our MechPac system. That's that straight torch with a start stop. So 2T, 4T. Then you've got the compressed air. That's how that works. You can check the purge. You're gonna use about 8 or 9 bar to the back of the machine. That's what you wanna supply it, 8 or 9 bar. And then it's gonna use about 6 bar, 5 or 6 bar for this Cutmaster 30 Plus. So the 30 is a great machine for really just about anything you'd find in a light industrial setting. It's capable of piercing 10 millimeter, so that's what 10 millimeter looks like right there. And it can edge start all the way up to 20 millimeter. So that gives you an idea there what that material looks like. So before I go piercing and cutting this material, I wanna have my PPE on. So even if you've got a hood like I'm about to put on, you wanna make sure, have your safety glasses. My hood, I really like to use a shade 7 for cutting. If I'm gouging and I'm looking right at that brightness of the arc, I like, you know, like shade 12, 11 at the least, but most of the time shade 12. Awesome auto dark hood. I like the fact that I can change the settings on there and not have to search around for another hood. Cover your skin, cover your hands, legs, feet, wear shoes. Don't be cutting in flip-flops, right? So, as soon as I pull that trigger, I get a pilot arc, right? Good to go. 30 amps, solid metal. Let's see a cut. Right, so that's some mild steel there, but that's definitely some interesting mild steel. It's got a different sound to it, so I wonder what the composition of that is. But still, beautiful, clean cut. Let's see what this max severance edge start is. So this is 20 millimeters. So I'm waiting on that arc to pop through the bottom. I'm gonna travel fairly slow through that. I wanna see that arc, there we go. Now I just keep that travel going forward. This is 20 millimeters on only a 30 amp system. 230 volt, 16 amp, single phase. Now as I approach the end of this cut here, I want to angle my torch just slightly. So it gives the arc toward the bottom of the cut a chance to catch up. I'm going to pause a little bit, do a little bit of travel pause, then finish that arc out. I know I was going all the way through that material, beginning to end. There was some dross, but that popped right off. And there you go. And you can see the striations, right? You can see those drag lines that are carrying about that 10 or 15 degree angle versus like on the regular material that's for the piercing cut rating, right? 10 millimeter versus 20 millimeter. So now let's pierce a hole in that. Piercing is not difficult. You just have to use a little technique. So when I pierce a hole, I'm gonna hold the torch at a slight angle, and then come down to vertical. I gotta give a place for those sparks to escape before it goes through the material. Since you're right there on the camera, I'm gonna go this way, spray the sparks this way and pierce a hole. Here we go. There we go, now I'm through. I'm gonna come around the circle. Waiting for that slug to fall out. There we go. So the slug fell out. You can see on that surface, right? Those sparks had to go out before they go down. And that's what you see on the surface of that. I scraped that, it's gonna come right off. Right, so there's a hole. Right through the material. All right, so that's mild steel. I'm not limited to just mild steel. I can cut anything that conducts electricity. So, if I wanted to cut some aluminum, some stainless, all right, so let's cut a little bit of that. Here's some aluminum, here's some stainless. Let's see what this looks like. Right through that. That was awesome. Just like that. So aluminum and stainless, you cut a little bit slower through the material, right? We're using compressed air. Compressed air has about 80% nitrogen, 20% oxygen. Well, aluminum and stainless don't react as positively to that oxygen like light carbon steel does, right? So the cut surface is gonna look a little bit different. So in stainless steel, you get that dark nitrided surface. You're gonna wanna touch that with a grinder before you weld it. Same thing with the aluminum, it has a very porous look to it. You're gonna wanna touch that with a grinder before you weld that as well. But beautiful, look how little the heat affected zone is. Really quite a nice cut when you compare that as well to mild steel, right? They all look pretty good. Powerful little machine. So you cut stainless, aluminum, mild steel, anything that conducts electricity, but you can also cut, like I showed you before, that expanded metal. So here's a piece of expanded metal. Cuts through rust as well, right? So you see that on there. Let's change this setting to expanded metal, okay? So now I'm in expanded metal. I also like using the expanded metal setting for gouging. So when we go to gouge, sometimes that arc can stretch far enough that the arc goes out. I don't want to have to let go and re-pull the trigger again. I'll just bring the torch back close to the material and the arc starts again. So for gouging, it's also quite beneficial. All right, so let's do this expanded metal. So you saw in the beginning that example of if you let go of the trigger and pull it between each, you'd see that. And then I pulled the trigger, held it solid all the way through to the end. So you kind of get a feel for what that's like. That's the convenience of that expanded metal mode. I can pull the trigger one time, zip, 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 right through the material. So now let's look at gouging. When I go to gouge, all I'm gonna do is change out this nozzle. I'm going to go to a gouging nozzle. Notice the machine knew when I disconnected the consumables, it's going to know that you're here. So from a safety standpoint, it's going to give you that setting again. So now I've put the gouging nozzle in. You can see the end of the nozzle is a little bit larger hole. It's also drilled a little bit differently. That's going to soften the arc, broaden it out, so that when I do a gouge, it's gonna have a really nice profile to it versus a cut that's really sharp and piercing. So, let's do that on this same material I pierced the hole on. I'm gonna do two different style gouges, just a straight push and one with a little motion so you can see what I'm doing. man, I just love that process. So gouging is gonna allow you to repair those welds, repair cracks, or even do weld preparation, gouge off rivets, nuts that are stuck, right? So you can really do a lot of different, very helpful applications with gouging. So with this one, I'm just pushing straight. I'm setting my torch angle quite shallow. That's what sets your depth, right? If I go too steep, that's gonna be a problem. I'll have sparks going both ways. I wanna set a really shallow angle. And then to make things wider, I applied a U shape. You can do different shapes, be creative. A V, a circle, a U. You can use that to create a different profile for your gouge. So there you go, cutting, piercing, gouging, mild steel, stainless, aluminum, expanded metal. Man, this system does it all. Great system, powerful package, very lightweight. It's only 11 kilograms, right? Very lightweight package. Single button control knob, super bright TFT, detachable torch and ground lead. That's really helpful when you want to stow and go. So, you've seen it all. You're going to love this machine. Go check it out at a local distributor and get you one.